Mana River Union, let's go!
Forest Blessing!
Sierra Leone!
Forest
Liberia.
Blessing!
Liberia!
La Côte d'Ivoire!
Forest Blessing!
Et la Guinée!
Let's protect our
forest!
And the animal trees and the mineral are things what we need to survive. If we don't manage it well and misuse everything, it can greatly affect our lives. What are you money, a hunting, farming, a logging?
Forest Blessings, Episode 9.
Let's protect our forest! Forest Blessing!
Hello, Seri, how are you? I'm Mr. Kumar.
Yes, I know. Hello, I'll see you around town.
I see that you are a businessman just like me. So this is where you do your business. What do you sell?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Kumar. You see, I can sell canned goods and other dry goods here. Would you like some rice, flour, wheat, sardine, or...
Sure! They need food from the neighborhood communities to work long hours.
Working in the forest?
Yes, I'm the guy that has come to town to positively impact the lives of the people.
To impact our lives?
Yes, Siri. So what else do you do?
Well, I sell these things to pay off my school fees at a community college in the big town.
That is wonderful. Mm-hmm. A smart young man. So what do you study at the community college?
I'm studying forestry.
I've been hearing about you and I want to have a word with you.
Okay, no problem. You can have a seat.
Thanks, but I suggest we meet at a special place where we can have lunch and drink some expensive wines.
Why don't we meet with the CFMC at the town square?
Well, I don't think that is the best thing to do.
Why not?
Look, this meeting is just for you and me. How much is your school fees again, by the way?
The cost of my fee is not important now. What is it that you want to discuss with me?
Forest business, of course. I want to sponsor you and give you the opportunity of free experience. And when you graduate, you can work for me.
Well, I'm so sorry. As the head of the community forest management committee, I can't discuss issues that involve the forest with all my colleagues.
Anyway, I just want to have a man-to-man discussion. So, here's something for you and your colleagues. We can meet later.
No. Sorry. I will suggest that you come over to my house where we can talk and so I can give you more information about the Community Forest Management Committee.
Well, okay. Will tomorrow evening be fine for you?
Sure.
Great. Let me buy 5 bags of rice, 20 cans of sardines, some tea and coffee for my workers.
No problem. What's the calculator? $275.
All right, Siri, yes, 300. Keep the change. My boys will put the goods in the truck. Boys, come put the items in the truck. I'm here to put smiles on the faces of people.
Excuse me, Dr. Ma.
Uh-huh.
I can't take this change. It's yours.
Come on, Siri. It's no big deal. This is tea money for business people like us.
No. I can't.
Okay then, keep it for me. When I come back to buy, you can deduct it.
Okay.
No problem. See you tomorrow, Siri.
Hello, Paka.
My son, Siri. How are you?
I'm doing fine.
Bale,
yes?
The daughter of Chiblama. How are you too?
Paka,
hmm?
I'm okay. Oh. How is the vegetable farm coming along?
The vegetables are coming along fine.
Thank you so much for this garden, Paka. You are 68 years old and still strong. And every year your farms are always prosperous.
You should know that I have been farming in Manazala town for over 40 years since I was an agriculture extension officer. So it is hard for me to lose when it comes to farming.
I love your hard work and invaluable pieces of advice.
Thank you, my son.
I believe with your help and support given to Sidi, we all can succeed in conserving our community forest.
So Sidi, what brings you and Bale to my vegetable farm today?
Well, yesterday, this new investor in town, one Mr. Kumar,
mm-hmm, I heard about him.
Very good. Came to my shop and said he wants to meet with me to discuss his investments in Mana Nzela Forest.
Well, my son, you got to be careful and take note of how the visit of the heart to the hen's house looks like.
He insisted that we have a meeting. In fact, I invited him.
My son, Sadie, I love your bravery in standing firm in protecting our remaining forest. But remember, you need to eat and your colleagues as well need to eat.
How about the fear that if no one stands up for the community, we will lose our forest resources with no tangible benefit for the community and its people?
My children, I believe that when our people accept new and better practices, we will move faster ahead than neighboring villages and towns, and we will be able to work with our neighbors across the border to share the same forest with us.
I agree with you, Parker.
I also fear that if the forest is not well managed, the next generation will have nothing to live on in the future.
Baka, I'm not going to be bought cheap, as I'm not in any mood to be fooled or moved by little gift or money.
You're right. Let me suggest to you, Sidi, that I come with you to the meeting with Mr. Kruma.
That is why we have come to invite you to the meeting with me.
Bale, I also want you to advise your father Chiblama to be careful with Mr. Kruma and the gifts the Greeks bring.
I've been telling him, but he is not listening. Coco had him convinced that doing business with Mr. Kruma will work miracles for the community.
Do you see the pull the firstborn male child can have on us?
And I know how bad you felt when your oldest son passed away.
You're right, Bale. But life goes on. You people are young. But let me tell you both something. Do not ever let small money lead you to do the wrong thing. As you know, I am a retired agriculture extension officer who has worked in the community for over 40 years.
That's true.
For my children, I'm still willing to learn new farming techniques, and I am still willing to teach the young generation about sustainable farming that will help in the development for our town and its young people. People like this Kruman comes in to polish all the resources and move on to the next town. We have to be careful with him. There are many people like him fooling people around our communities.
My father has always said that besides you being a good friend, you are the smartest person he has ever met, and he admires how you carry on your role as quarter chief.
I'm only a high school graduate, but I have studied a lot of different fields, and I have certificates from various agricultural trainings and workshops. These trainings have helped me make wise decisions over the years.
Your wisdom is unmatched. Mr. Kutna offered to buy me the most expensive wine, and he even asked me how much I pay for my school fees.
Do not be fooled and allow this man to owe you by paying your school fees and doing favors for you.
I refused and instead invited him to my house.
That's good.
I hope you can be there to help give me some of your wisdom as I have this discussion with this Mr. Kruma man.
Please, Parker, we need you to help Sadie because he has tried to corrupt members of the Forest Elephant football team.
I will be there, my dear, and Sadie. You can count on me at any time for support.
Thank you so much, Parker. Mana Nzela is forever indebted to you.
Sadie, let's leave Parker so he can continue weeding his farm. Oh, Parker, leave these young plants. This is feature writing plant. This is the Aroko. Here is ironwood tree. That is a mahogany. Next is the bush pineapple. Leave them. We are clearing your farm and plant more fruit trees seedlings, so your farm will provide all what you want in the future.
Thanks again, Parker. We are leaving now.
Okay, my children. See you again soon.
Good evening, Mr. Kuma.
Good evening, Sidi.
You are welcome to my little humble home.
Thank you, Sidi. I appreciate you taking time to meet me.
May I offer you something to drink?
I will drink the wine if it is fresh from God to man. But I've been very busy working at the site.
You have a seat, sir.
Thank you.
So, what do you want to talk about?
Sidi, my brother, how is life in Mana Nzela? I heard Forest Elephant football team won the other day. Do they still have elephants in that forest? I killed all. They need to change their name.
Life is not so bad. We are working on to make ends meet. And one day, when I have completed my graduation or my education, whatever we determine, I believe I will be a political leader for my people in this district.
That is very commendable, Sidi. It is exactly what I have seen that brings me to see you tonight. Sidi, let me tell you about myself. I grew up very poor and could barely afford a decent meal a day.
Look how difficult it can be.
I struggled through high school and almost did not complete university until I met my mentor and benefactor to pay my fees and make me into the man I am today. That is what I want to make you into.
Mr. Krumah, so pressing the feeding, the hardship, God being my helper, I'm going to succeed in this life.
I also believe in God, and I strongly believe that God has sent me to change your life. This is why he brought me to you. Henceforth, your school fees will be covered.
To change my life? Why me, of all the young people in Manamezela?
I heard you are a very influential man on the Community Forest Management Committee, and people listen to you in this town.
Is this what people have been telling you?
Of course, yes. It would be a honor for a person like you to work with me, and together we both can become very rich.
Hello, CD and Mr. Krumah. How are you guys tonight?
Hello, Paka.
Hi there, Mr. Carr. What brings you here at this time of the night?
I was invited to this meeting by Sidi. What is the nature of your meeting, Sidi?
Mr. Krumah has come to...
Well, Mr. Carr, I've come with a proposition that will make both you and Sidi very rich. That is the nature of the meeting.
I see. And what do we have to do to get these riches?
Just for you and Sidi here to play the game along with me.
What game are you talking about?
I have come to Manamezela to do business. You have seen my trucks and power saws and men in the forest working day and night, logging and clearing.
And who gave you the right to do logging and clearing here?
The chief, investors waiting for the products that I will provide, and I would like for you, Sidi, to head my operations.
Just wait a little. This forest is a community forest, and we have parts that we don't intend to use for commercial purposes because certain trees are protected and there are endangered animals and species there also. You cannot just go into the forest and cut down trees. That forest creates condition that favors high yield or crops.
There was no consultation with the Community Forest Management Committee. You have to show proof, Mr. Krumah. Where is your agreement?
I have an agreement.
The chief and the CFMC will have to come to an agreement with any company that wants to work in our forest. And the agreement should have full signature, including my own.
Where is the agreement?
I did not bring it with me.
In the agreement, we will also give you guardians on which trees you can log and how far you can go into the forest.
Your agreement is very strict. The one I have with the chief is very simple. And I like simple agreements.
Then you don't have a real agreement.
And it doesn't end there, oh. The town has to benefit from your company being here.
Yes, you will.
We need schools, clinics, and social cash payments that will uplift the community.
We don't surrender our forest so easily.
Gentlemen, you better get on board.
No amount of money can make me sell off our community forest and our protected animals.
Are you sure, Sidi? I can tell you that every man has his price, my son.
Mr. Krumah, I think it's time that you leave.
Sidi, are you asking me out of the house? I can make you a very rich man. This old man car has lived his life. Don't let him spoil yours.
You cannot bully or threaten me into working for you and your criminal gang. Please leave.
Gentlemen, I'm disappointed. However, I'm willing to come back to the table when you guys are ready. Let me leave my business card.
We want to see your agreement with Chief Blama Uleo.
Yes. When you bring that agreement, we will all sit down and talk about it.
Okay. That's not a problem. I have it. Your chief's signature is on it.
Youth in our communities know our forests and where animals could be found. They can earn money as guides for tourists visiting our rural areas.
Mana River Union, let's go!
Forest Blessing.
Sierra Leone.
Forest
Liberia.
Blessing.
Liberia.
La Côte d'Ivoire.
Forest Blessing.
Et la Guinée.
Let's protect our forest.
In Forest Blessings today, Louisa Gizi play Mamandoa. Amanda Yasia Sally played Bale. Joseph Horace P. played Sidi Tivox Robert played Bakon. Doris Wakwi played Bolu. Nathaniel Va played Walati. Alvin Brown played Omekai. Mata Akosa played Dekonti. Aaron Dixon played Mr. Chroma. The Forest Blessings radio drama is brought to you from the American people through the USAID funded West Africa Biodiversity and Climate Change WABEC program, and it is produced by Eddie Theater Productions.
Our blessings, let's try to preserve our blessings. Forest blessings, make it everlasting.
Forest blessings,
forest blessings,
forest blessings,
forest blessings.